called the Cambridge program. So we actually have two options that you can apply for if you choose to come to our school. So I'll start off with talking a little bit about Cambridge. So Cambridge is, obviously it's an advanced academic program. It's very similar to IB. I know a lot of you have probably heard of IB. It's pretty similar to AP. And the difference between those is what I would consider basically your learning style. So in the Cambridge program, the way that the classes are set up is that they are very project-based, they're very hands-on, and very collaborative. Also, when they take tests, they don't take multiple-choice tests. The teachers have a lot of autonomy as far as what part of the curriculum they teach, depending on what the interests are of their students. But it's a good option for those of you who are interested in an advanced academic program that allows you to work with others and be very collaborative. Also, a really great thing about the Cambridge program is that it starts ninth grade year. So whenever you come in as a ninth grade student, you would have some what they call ICSE classes. So ICSE classes are like the entry level Cambridge classes, and they are taken in ninth and 10th grade. And then in 11th and 12th grade, they call those ACE classes. And this is just a little bit of information about them. The ICSE classes are on a 5.5 grading scale, and the ACE are on a 6.0 grading scale. So this past year, this is our fifth class coming in this year of Cambridge students. We were the first school in Alabama to bring the Cambridge program, even though it's very popular in other parts of the country. So our class that just graduated, our class of 2020, they left with over $3.2 million in scholarships. They had an average ACT score of 30.4, which is good. Your ACT score is going to be important to you when you're in high school because that is money. You want to have a great ACT score so that you can get scholarships if you're interested in going to college. And the last great thing I would say about the Cambridge program is that it's very much becomes like a little family. This is just a few pictures of some of the students. When you ask them what are their most fun things that they've done in Cambridge, they always have a Gatsby dance. They play baseball. We have a picture of them. They built their own homecoming club because we have a homecoming parade every year. But also, you are not tied into it. It won't consume your entire life. You can do other academies in addition to Cambridge if that's what you choose to do. So that's one option if you want to apply for that program. But we also have a second signature academy, and that's the Academy of Coastal Studies. Now, like I was saying, because of our proximity to the water, we're down close to Bayou Labatry. Our academy is Coastal Studies, and it actually covers five different pathways of the different aspects of the community in that area and in south of the Gulf Coast, down here where we all live, that would allow you to gain experience, get certifications that if you wanted to go out after high school and get a job or work while you went to school, you would have some type of experience in some of the very popular, topics, places to work around here. My brain's fried this week. All right, so the first pathway is agri-science. Raise your hand if you've ever gone to the fair and you've seen all the hogs. Y'all ever go see the pigs at the fair? Y'all don't walk by the pigs? Well, this year we didn't have very many, but one of the things that agri-science covers is the farming community of that part of the county. And last year we had about 35 hogs that the students raised, so they raised them starting at the beginning of the year. They take them to the fair and they sell them and they get to keep that profit. They also learn woodworking, electrical, so if you like working with your hands, it's a really fun program. There's a few of our things. So next is we have coastal environmental science and fisheries management and aquaculture, and they're very closely related. So the coastal environmental science pathway is very much marine biology, environmental management, environmental science, and it covers every things get picked back up, our students will take it back out and replant it. So the next pathway would be fisheries management and aquaculture, and that's where we would tie in the crawfish that I was just talking about. So this really goes over the seafood industry and those who are interested in farming and being involved with that. So on campus, we have a huge crawfish enclosure. This is the top left, and the one on the right is pictures of that, where we actually raise crawfish on campus. So right now we have around 6,000 crawfish. The students that are involved in these classes are out here hands-on every single day, working with those, working with the plants. And our goal is to have up to 50,000 so that we can have a small commercial operation going on at the school. So that's one thing that we're building toward. Now, they're huge. Some of them are huge, like the one in the bottom left. He's been with us for a few years, so he's pretty big. Now, in addition to that, the other pictures that you see of the water, we also have 100 acres of land where we have a oyster farm. So it's 100 acres, and we have two blocks of that, and the rest of it we lease out to local small oyster farmers who are trying to get started. And we work with Auburn Shellfish Lab, and they have two of our blocks, and then they help us with our two, and they hire our students, they do internships with them, and they actually raise oysters. So if you've ever wondered what an oyster farm looks like, the picture on the bottom right is one of our blocks, and so it's just lines, and the cages that you see above the water there are just there under the water, and the students go out and tumble on, like the guy in the top middle is doing. He goes out there and you have to tumble them. You have to make the oysters tumble and move around every now and then so that they'll grow bigger. And when they get bigger, they split them. And the bottom middle is what they look like right now, and they're pretty close to needing to be split so they'll have more room to move around. But anyways, if anything like that is of interest to you, it is constant hands-on activities with these classes. You learn so much, and it's really fun to be out there in it and get to see how things work. And if you're someone who's like me and doesn't like to sit all the time and likes to work with your hands, it's something that's perfect for you. Now, we also have recreation, travel, and tourism, which is our culinary classes. They also go over things like hotel management, event planning, all the things that go along with the tourism industry. And then this is some pictures of them at some of their competitions. And then lastly, we have what's called maritime and industrial technology. So we're partnered with Ingalls Shipbuilding. Does anybody know where Ingalls is? Where? Well, that's Austell, but they are very similar. Does anybody else want to try to take a guess where Ingalls is? They're actually in Pascagoula, Mississippi, and they're the largest naval shipbuilder in the world. 2 years ago, they came in and did a huge renovation of our welding lab. And right now, what we have on campus is the pictures of the students welding. That's our welding lab on campus. So if it's something you're interested in, you take those classes on campus. And if it's something you decide you wanted to do as a career, your senior year, we have what's called the Ingalls Shipbuilder Academy. And what those students do is they get on a bus in the morning, they ride to Ingalls, which is actually in Pascagoula. It's not too far from us, but they ride on the bus, they take their first two blocks they spend at Ingalls in their maritime training center, where they learn all the trades from electrical, they even have crane driving simulators, they learn how to do naval painting, anything you can imagine that could possibly go into building a Navy ship. And then the rest of the day they ride back and they take whatever classes they have left. Now, when those students graduate, when they walk across the stage in May, Ingalls specially says, what was your favorite thing? Did you like electrical? Did you like welding, pipe fitting? You know, where did you fit in? What did you do the best with? And they offer them a job there in that section. And the good thing about that is they start off very well paid. Within 2 years, they're making between $65,000 and $70,000 a year. And also, if you wanted to go to college, they do tuition reimbursement. So you can work there and take college courses while you work. They have a branch of Mississippi Gulf Coast Community College, which is on site there. they'll take all the classes. They'll just fill up their electives with all those classes, and they end up completing both pathways. So let's say you had two things maybe you're interested in. Maybe y'all want to do recreation and tourism. Maybe y'all want to do business. You will usually have room in your schedule where you can do both of those. So in addition to those academies, we also have a business and marketing academy, a performing arts, and then we also, if you are interested in anything at the Bryant Career Tech Center, you can go and take those classes. So that was a lot. Does anybody have any questions? Yeah. Well, I really appreciate y'all's time and attention. Remember that the academy application is open right now. If you're wanting to attend a high school that's not in your district, you need to make sure that you get on there and apply before December 18th, because that is the deadline this year. And it might creep up on. It's kind of early in the year. It seems early in the year. But you want to make sure if you're wanting to attend, or even if you're thinking about going to a different school, maybe, you know, you haven't totally decided, I would go ahead